It's been a busy month for iodine maker Iofina, with the appointment of a new chief executive, a production update and interim results. Well, to talk us through the highlights of the past month is the new chief executive and president, Tom Becker. Now, Tom, first half results first. How was the company affected by declining iodine prices in the period? Because the net loss increased by $1 million. I wondered if there was a correlation.
Yes, Sarah, there is a slight correlation between reducing iodine prices in the marketplace and our net loss for the period. Anytime you're an iodine producer and the iodine prices are declining, there is going to be an impact on your bottom line. However, in the period, we're actually expanding our operations as well. So there's in addition to the iodine prices declining, the net loss that we saw in the period also has to do with the depreciation and amortization of the new iodine plants that we brought online in the period. One good thing I will say is that while our net loss did increase, our EBITDA was positive for the period. So even in the declining iodine market, we're working well as a company to reduce our SG&A and plant costs and becoming EBITDA for the period. So we look forward in the future to be able to decrease that net loss and become totally positive in the future.
Okay, well, there was an element of disappointment though with production shortfalls due in part to fracking. Now, how can this be overcome when fracking is gathering acceptance and momentum and it's not conducive to your production model?
Well, there's certain things with fracking that we can control and things we can't control. So we're working with our operators at our particular sites to reduce and minimize the impact of fracking that it has on our operations. Over the past few months, as I've become more involved in the operations, we've had better relationships with our saltwater providers to reduce the impact of fracking. In the future, in the winter months, we will see less of an impact of fracking because the fracking in the area in the winter months is reduced. And long term, if you think about it, fracking in the area will actually produce more produced water, which will end up giving more water for our plants and therefore have them produce more iodine on a per plant basis.
Now, in terms of those plants, they're called iosol plants. Are they paying for themselves yet?
Yeah, they are. They are paying for themselves. Each of these plants is producing iodine. Some are actually better than others. And our cash position month over month is increasing. So these plants are producing iodine and paying for themselves. We have a model where these plants should be paying for themselves over a 12 to 24 month period of time, and we're on track for that.
Now, in terms of your Iofina chemicals, what new offerings can we expect from this halogen-based specialty chemical business?
So at Iofina Chemical, we do provide a number of different halogen-based chemicals, and iodine is our focus. In the past couple of years, we've introduced new products to the marketplace, a lot of iodide salt kind of solutions and some other type of iodic acid type of compounds, and we continue to put more effort into our R&D resources to provide more offerings to the marketplace, and especially looking into some new applications of iodine in the environmental remediation kind of areas.
Now, you raised funds in April. Do you have enough funds still to assist the growth of iodine production and plant expansion?
Yeah, that's correct. We did do a $5 million fundraising in April, and that was specifically for expansion of our iosol plants. We do have those funds now. In fact, we're sitting on a cash position today of about $7.5 million, and those funds will be used for future iodine expansion growth. One thing I will say is that we are strategically looking into this growth pattern moving forward. The company has been aggressive in its growth in the course of 2013 and the early part of 2014, and we're going to be ensure that we strategically grow our company in the proper way using our capital funds so that we aren't overspending on any kind of plants in the future and that we build our plants at ideal strategic locations so we can maximize the iodine that we produce at each individual plant and minimize the cost.
See, I'm just wondering how aggressive you are. You are new to the role. What steps are you, as the chief executive, taking to make Iofina a global leader in the iodine industry?
Well, Sarah, I've been involved in the iodine industry for a number of years. I have been CEO of Iofina Chemical and have a number of contacts and acceptance into the iodine marketplace. Iofina has to have growth in order to become the technology leader in iodine that we strive to be. In the U.S. iodine market, iodine is imported almost exclusively into the U.S. market. It provides us a great niche to be the leading producer in iodine, and I look forward to the challenge of taking Iofina to the next level as the leader in iodine worldwide.
So you've obviously had full immersion within the business, but how do you intend to maximize shareholder value?
Well, one of the first things I did when I came in was try to identify where Iofina is and what short-hanging fruit that we have in order to maximize shareholder value. The recent additions of Ioplants 3 through 6 provided Iofina with more iodine production than we had in the past. However, there are some immediate steps that we undertook and we're currently undertaking now to minimize cost, reduce SG&A expenses, and increase shareholder value. So those kind of low-hanging fruit we're looking at right now to immediately provide shareholder value, but we're also looking at some long-term growth in order to provide long-term shareholder value.
Tom Becker, Chief Executive of Iofina, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thanks a lot.